Hello everybody and welcome back to Let's Play Super Mario 64. My name's Hyjolo and we're gonna get straight into this flying cap level, which is kinda needed to complete Bob-omb Battlefield, which is what we're gonna be doing. And I'm gonna be getting this star and I'm probably gonna do a few hundred coin levels. Which is alright. This level's sort of difficult. The flying controls in this game suck, and because you have like a time limit with the flying cap. That also sucks, but hopefully I can get this like first try. I'm going really slow, oddly enough, which I'm not used to with these flying areas. I'm used to like, oh yeah, I'm going fast now. But we got the star unlocked, and I just have to get to the center platform. Oh no, 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 okay. And then we hit the button, and we have the flying cap, the winged cap, as it's called, or just winged cap, that's unlocked for every other level that needs it, and let's get our star. So, good thing I finished that, like, first try. Because we're gonna have to do some long levels, finally. Just get on track. So we're gonna go back to Bob-omb Battlefield, get the two stars I need. The 100 coins is kind of annoying, but I can do both of these stars in the same run. So that's a better thing to think about. So, 100 coins. This is gonna take, like, if I remember, it takes between, like, 7 and infinite amount of time. So, but with the wing cap, some more coins are easier to pick up, so we'll scoop those up a bit easily in that mirror. In fact, I'm gonna do those now because, a weird thing that this game does, which, like, it doesn't have a designated location for the 100 coin star. It just shows up wherever you get the star, or like the 100th coin. So sometimes you can get it in an impossible place to reach if you reach the max height of your jump. So there's quite a bit of thought put into where you get your last coins and whatnot. So we're gonna just blast back to the island and sky. Oh no. Okay, well I landed on the slope. I don't know if I would take damage anyways, but better safe than sorry if you picking up what I'm putting down. Maybe I should aim at the tree. I don't know. See, it's like really not a good spot. Yeah, I think I overshot again. What am I doing? This is not a good thing to be doing on a long mission. I could fast forward. I don't know how to fast forward on my video editor. Just kidding. Okay, we'll just aim right at the top of that cloud's bump. Bump. Oh yeah, it's some sign action. You know, I could have just grabbed a flying cap from the bottom of the stage and just use the cannon and fly up here, or glide some. And the way that the other star works, other than the 100 coins, is that you had to hit the center coin in each of the rings. And it gets a bit more difficult over time because you can't exactly see what the coins are. Because you keep collecting them. And I keep overshooting that last one, so that would mean that I should probably aim lower. Oh, hey, let's go. We go back in the cannon. 49 coins, that's pretty good. See, I just got the last rings of the stars there. But I'm not gonna collect it. I'm gonna try and get more coins now. Because that's what I need to do to make things easy. So you can spin around all of the wooden poles and release coins. 5 coins to be exact. And I don't think you get any coins for ground pounding the poles, so keep that in mind. $5 more coins. $5 for pawn. Any. That you can't put on. That is a commercial. It's so good. I don't watch commercials anymore because I don't have TV. It's so awkward not having the game music to listen to me because it feels like I'm just that kind of. It feels more like I'm talking to myself than like talking while playing the game. Because I don't know. I'm just hoping that the music doesn't go bad. That's really it for that. We're almost done collecting coins. Only about 10 more coins left. I'm gonna skip that extra life because I don't really need it that much. Could kill enemies, but I feel like there's another location with a lot of easy access coins. Oh, under the bridge. And I'm gonna get the chain shot. Oh, he's trying to no-scope me. Okay. We just gotta get the coins, We're just hit and run. I don't think I went under the bridge. Oh, I did. There's bombs here. Okay. So, I think I'm just gonna have to get this star and the other one, and that's gonna be it for the episode. Maybe, actually, on Thwomp's Fortress, it only takes, like, 3 minutes, I believe. I don't remember exact times for completing levels, but it's like those, the first few missions, I just kind of remember it. So yeah, there's 2 stars right there, and we're about 31 minutes into this recording, setting the whole session, not the episode. And we're gonna complete the second level. The first 2 levels are gonna be completed in this whole Let's Play in episode 3. And then eventually everything's gonna slow down, and I'm not gonna be able to complete 1 world per episode and a half. Take like 2 episodes to do that, so I'll just pick the red coin level just in case. So, plants give 5 coins. Yeah, blue coins are 5 coins, just so you know. This is back when, in games where different point and like currency amounts just for different colors of the money, which, you know, I get, that's like saving on resources, so that's passable. And because like in the newer Mario games, they just literally put what the number of the value of the coins now. So see, we're at 36. I'm gonna try and get this right now. You know what? It can, you know, one try is not really worth it. And then most levels, I think all levels after like the first one, I don't know what the first one you had, but there's blue coin switches, and like there are quite a few levels where if you just don't get all the blue coins from the switch, you like you just lost the whole star for getting 100 coins. So we're at 64 coins right now, and I'm 36 trying to do mental math. Great. Yeah, I worked the other night. I've been working there for about a month now, and I got to like start counting money in the registers for like the first time. And there's a lot of mental math in there. Like they give calculators, But like the man, like the manager who owns the building, but she's like not exactly the boss of the whole business or whatever. I guess she's like the boss. I don't know. I really don't know like who owns the building of where I work. All I know is that the managers are called D3s or some weird name. And like so, she's kind of intimidating. So like when she was teaching me, like, counting change, she was like right behind me. She's like, how much is $12.16 plus $9.87? Jeez. I need one more coin. Yeah, we, oh yeah, what's poppin'? So that's gonna be it for, wait, if I can just get it. So that's gonna be it for this episode of Let's Play Super Mario 64. I hope you enjoyed it. If you like this episode, feel free to leave a like, and it helps the channel grow. And if you like this episode or have seen the first two episodes and want to see more, like feel free to hit the subscribe button, or I don't know if it's a button anymore. YouTube just got rid of Google Plus. But anyways, yeah. So you can subscribe to me if you want to see my uploads as soon as they happen. And next episode, we're going to be starting a new world. I believe I'm going to be doing the ice levels, so that's going to be pretty fun. So, thanks for watching, and see you next time.